A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 29th October, on the front page you have government signals shift in stand, allows EU MPs to visit Srinagar. So embassy in Delhi has said that parliamentarians from European Union are in India in their personal capacity and they've been allowed to visit Srinagar, the capital of the state of Jammu and Kashmir. So it's been nearly 3 months since the decision on Article 370 has been taken by the Union government, when 370 has been revoked and it has been decided to bifurcate the state of Jammu and Kashmir into two union territories, Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh. This will come into effect on 31st October. So, Congress political party says that this is outright insult of the parliament because no Indian MP has been allowed to visit so far and EU MPs have been allowed. And this is Islamic State Chief Baghdadi killed in US raid. So US President Donald Trump announced that the Islamic State group's elusive leader Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi has been killed, dying like a dog in a night raid by US Special Forces in Northwest Syria. So he was the terrorist was cornered and he set off his suicide vest. Then this is European Union grants Brexit delay. So European Union has now agreed to give a 3 month flexible delay to Britain's departure from European Union. So this has been announced. Then below you have police in gun battle with Maoists in Kerala. So the Kerala police said that they have either injured or killed at least three suspected Maoists in a gun battle between the armed irregulars and Thunderbolt commandos in the Agadi forest of Palakkad district of Kerala. And below you have capital's air quality dips to season's worst, that is post Deepavali air, you know, as such is cleaner compared with previous years, but it has gone from very poor to severe under air quality index in New Delhi. And this is second round of smart cities Amrut may roll out in 2020. So this is regarding the smart cities mission. So second round of this urban development scheme of smart cities as well as of Amrut, that is Atal mission for rejuvenation and urban transformation. So second round of both could be rolled out in 2020 is what the Union Minister of State for Housing and Urban Affairs has said. So in the first round we had seen smart cities mission, it covered 100 cities. So plan was to have 100 cities, a little more than 100 were selected, 100. And this is 50% complete is what he says. That is 50 cities have been will be completed by December 2019. About Amrut scheme also, rejuvenation and urban transformation, this scheme was a 5-year scheme started in 2015. So water sewage treatment projects have been completed under it. So Amrut scheme, you know, the criteria was that of those cities which have population of 1 lakh. So 65% of urban population areas were covered. So now remaining would also be covered under Amrut 2 scheme is what the minister says. On page 6 you have statue of mob violence victim installed in UP's Bulandshahr. So this is a statue to honor Sumit Dalal, the young resident of Sayana in Bulandshahr, who lost his life in a mob violence following rumors of cow slaughter in the neighboring Maha village. This happened in December 2018. So, a statue of his has been installed here. And below you have, after Manipur, Arunachal wants to be kept out of Naga peace deal. So, this is now a demand being made in Arunachal Pradesh. Government should take a stand on the issue clearly and keep itself out of the Naga peace deal, because Naga group, the Naga separatist faction, which is their NSC and IM, with which the central government is negotiating a deal, they want Naga state to be created, which is comprising of regions from neighboring northeastern states too. So Manipur clearly stated it will be kept, it should be kept out of Naga peace deal. So in Arunachal also similar demand has been made. On page 7 you have Civil service probationers train on Statue of Unity. So 500 newly recruited bureaucrats will be participating in a 6-day foundation course. This is the first ever common foundation course Aram for 2019 batch of probationer civil servants, which has begun at the Statue of Unity in Kevadia, Gujarat, where around 500 newly recruited bureaucrats are undergoing 6-day training. So here you can see the World Bank President David Malpass addressed the probationers here, and also Aramb, the foundation course, will conclude on October 31, and it is said to be a fitting tribute to the Iron Man of India, that is Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, for whom the Statue of Unity has been built. It is his statue, and it is his birth anniversary on October 31, which is celebrated as Rashtriya Ekta Divas. So the first ever event will be organized recognizing his commitment, in which even Prime Minister and Home Minister and other top functionaries of the center will participate. On page 9 you have, this is World Health Organization study saying unintended pregnancy endangers mother and child both. So it emphasizing on need for high quality family planning. This is regarding Assam government's policy that for job eligibility you cannot have more than 2 children. But Muslim leader here says that the rule cannot stop Muslims from producing children. And this is Air India painting Ek Omkar symbol on Boeing 787, celebrating 550th birth anniversary of Guru Nanak. And this is Super Cyclone Kiar moves away from Indian coast. So Super Cyclone Kiar in the Arabian Sea had moved westwards and away from the Indian coast, according to Indian Meteorological Department. So Kiar is around 830 km west-southwest of Mumbai as such, and east-northeast of Salalah in Oman. And it is very likely to move west-northwards now. So it will move towards Gulf of Aden. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Limits of Hype. So it says, while retaining power via post-poll tie-up, BJP will have to recognize the mandate's nature. So this is in the context of Haryana. So it has post-poll tie-up has been done with JJP, and independent MLAs are also supporting BJP. But the editorial says that the mandate's nature has to be recognized by BJP. And this is death of a terrorist. So this is the claim made that Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi, founder leader of Islamic State, has been killed. He detonated his suicide vest when the US troops, surrounded him. So he's dead. But then the editorial says the conditions that gave rise to Islamic State still remain. So if the leader is dead, does not mean that the Islamic State is no longer a threat. So that is the point emphasized on. The lead article, settling the Ayodhya case once and for all. So this is regarding the Ayodhya title dispute case, which is going on, and the Supreme Court would give its verdict soon. So it says there must be an understanding that in the outcome, there is neither victor nor vanquished. And here you have election takeaways for the Congress. So it says, though encouraging, Haryana and Maharashtra results are no firm sign that the party is on the comeback trail. On op-ed page, you have the power of ordinary people. So this is regarding Mahatma Gandhi, the history regarding his weekend retreat at Oxford in 1931 and his viewpoints then. And this is the many gaps in NCRB data. So it says, without methodological clarity, policy making is a challenge. So National Crime Records Bureau came up with this data, its report on 2017. It was delayed. And methodological clarity is not there. So this article says that without that, policy making is a challenge. So we had seen how there were some things which are not put into the report, which the Home Ministry itself admitted, like on lynching, there is no clarity, so it was not put into the report. So it does not give a clear picture then. And this is vaping is injurious to health. So this is regarding e-cigarettes. So measures have been taken against e-cigarettes in US also, and that could result in a dip in sales there. On page 13 you have countdown begins for JNK's transition. So process of formation of two union territories will now begin on 31st October. So this will begin with the swearing in of lieutenant governors. And this says India Saudi to form strategic council. So Kashmir is unlikely to get any attention from Saudi rulers, is what has been stated when India and Saudi Arabia sign an agreement for creating a bilateral strategic partnership council. This will be during the official visit of Prime Minister Narendra Modi to Riyadh. So this council will include multiple sections. No, it will have the External Affairs Ministry, Niti Aayog, and counterpart organizations from Saudi Arabia as part of it. On international page, you have this coverage on Baghdadi's history as such. He was killed in Syria. And then you have, this is third Brexit delay comes with conditions. So that's also there on front page. So European Union won't renegotiate divorce agreement is what it has clearly stated now. Then on business page, you have Supreme Court order, Mittal knocks on government door. So we had seen regarding the Supreme Court order on adjusted gross revenue, the way it is calculated. So Supreme Court had upheld the way it has been calculated by Telecom Ministry, the Department of Telecom as such. And the telecom companies have to pay this amount as dues to the government, which they have not paid yet. So the amount, the interest, and also interest on the total amount have to be paid. So telecom firms, it says, owes billions of dollars in statutory dues, that as dues to the government that they have not fully provisioned for. So they are already in trouble, and now this verdict further, you know, would bog them down. So Sunil Bharti Mittal of Airtel has knocked on the government's doors seeking for relief. And this is ambiguity in policy to be blamed for Supreme Court order on AGR. So this is again the further detail on this adjusted gross revenue given, that there's ambiguity in policy because of which the Supreme Court order came in this case the way it has. And here you have deep discounts by e-commerce firms hitting GST revenue. So Confederation of All India Traders has written to Finance Minister alleging that GST revenue to the government due to deep discount by e-commerce firms, particularly Amazon and Flipkart, is reducing the GST revenue. It's affecting it drastically. And these firms, e-commerce giants, are actually under loss, and they have narrowed their loss. Amazon India has narrowed its loss. Rival Flipkart has also, see, the loss is 3,837 crores for Flipkart and 5,685 crores for Amazon. So that is it. The last page has sports related news. So these were the important headlines. Thank you.